to roll.
We are the nation.
We're back on Shotgun, and speaking of attitude, here comes the new nation.
The tag team contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first to be accompanied by fellow Nation of Domination member, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, at a total combined weight of 588 pounds.
New leaders of the nation, the Rock and Owen Hart. I'm not sure if any having a powwow, figuring out who knows each other's role. What do you make of this whole Owen Hart joining the nation?
Well, it was just a total shock to everyone that Owen Hart did what he did to Ken Shamrock a couple of weeks ago on Raw. Then last week we find out Owen is now a member of the nation. And we also found out that he has equal billing with The Rock.
That's right.
Now, The Rock fought for months to get power and control, to be the ruler. And he's giving it away? He's giving half of his power away to Owen Hart?
Well, I think The Rock realized that Owen Hart was vulnerable. The Rock saw a golden opportunity to strengthen the nation, to put it up there as perhaps the most powerful force in the World Wrestling Federation. Owen Hart was vulnerable. He had had enough. He was sick of being outnumbered. His true family, his brothers, deserted him, left him, and he had a family now to deal with in the nation.
Well, I think, yeah, maybe was it The Rock who went to Owen, or maybe Owen went to The Rock, but nonetheless, the relationship is struck and business is being done now between Owen Hart and the nation. And Kama's got the hat and the cigar still in his mouth. What's the deal with that?
He calls himself the godfather of the nation, Kama Mustafa, hammering away on John Crystal. Sunglasses, hat, cigar in tow.
Man, oh man, well, Kama, D'Lo, and Owen Hart are going to go right out in six-man tag team warfare at Over the Edge on May 31st. And they're going right after Triple H and DX.
Tell you what, a big issue to be settled between Owen Hart and Triple H. Perhaps part of it may be settled at Over the Edge in your house just a few weeks away as Kama now whips Bob Starr into the corner and hammers him down with authority. And there goes the hat.
Well, the hat, the sunglasses, the cigar are all going down in the corner. The tag is made. Here comes D'Lo Brown.
I'll tell you what, it's all about attitude now, isn't it?
Boy, it certainly is.
D'Lo with the big right hand. I'll tell you what, perhaps the most underrated superstar in the entire World Wrestling Federation today. This kid's got it all. 300 pounds and agility and quickness like you just saw.
Certainly is a certainly loves putting the bad mouth on people and learning at the hand of The Rock now is D'Lo Brown.
Bob Starr is seeing stars right now. There's the backbreaker by D'Lo.
And what kind of force is Owen Hart going to be now in the nation? I mean, certainly the nation was strong before. You put Owen Hart in, it's better than ever.
Wow!
Oh,
what
man!
A moonsault by D'Lo!
I mean, that's like primetime Deion Sanders making a pick. Just popping up and saying what time it is.
Look at this one now.
I mean, moonsault. This guy's 300 pounds, folks. And look at that.
And here comes the godfather, Kama, into the ring. The martial arts expert with a big right hand to the side of the head.
Kama, an experienced boxer, a tie fighter, a shoot fighter. He's done it all in his career. I mean, this man has boxed George Foreman. He's boxed Mike Tyson. He's done everything. Now, in the nation, certainly, when you put the nation against DX, two of the most powerful forces in the World Wrestling Federation colliding in a six-man at Over the Edge on May 31st. Man, sparks are going to fly.
Oh, what an elbow by Kama. I'll tell you what, Kevin. Oh, here's a cover now by Kama with a jalot. Just two before Starr, for some reason, gets his left shoulder up. Tell you what, Kevin. The nation was a formidable force before they added Owen. Now, it's unreal. Kama misses with the elbow, and here comes John Crystal now into the ring, hammering away with the big right hands, trying to knock the Supreme Fighting Machine off his feet. Crystal again, and a kick to the midsection. Kama is all strength. He's about strength, and here we're going to get an example of it. Face first into the mat.
Man, after this match, we're going to show you some of that Sable training footage everybody's been talking about.
Kama with the cover now, but wait a minute. I think D'Lo wants a little bit.
Boy, they are just, this is a day at the office for D'Lo and Kama.
Uh-oh, look out. What a move this is. If D'Lo goes for the lowdown, this one's all over.
Wow!
Man, he turned his body in midair. There's two. The nation victorious.
Here are your winners, Kama Mustafa and D'Lo.
Do you believe the agility of D'Lo Brown?
I hope we got the shot from our vantage point over here. to the right of the camera, where we saw D'Lo Brown change direction in midair and first impressive face first slam. And well, look at this. Here it is. Unbelievable. The lowdown and the victory for the nation.
And you know what? Kevin Sable's been training for her public confrontation with Marvelous Mark Merrill this Monday on Raw. Take a look. Monday live for the rousing public confrontation, guaranteed to be more than just a verbal confrontation.
You mean I gotta wait till Monday to see more of Sable?
You can see Miro too.
Who?
Still to come on Shotgun, the aftermath of that grueling no-holds-barred match with Mick Foley and Terry Funk.
And up next, the look at the rivalry that continues between Double J and the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman.